Hello everyone. I'm gonna say good evening because it's 5:25, and I've got some reading to do later. And I thought, well, I don't know, because it's technically the evening, isn't it? It's still light, but it's still light up until what, 9 o'clock still? It's warm. I hope you've enjoyed your Tuesday. This is your general tarot reading for, see, it's August time. This is why the strength card is coming up all the time. Hope you're well. Right, so this is your general tarot reading. No fixed sign, no fixed person. They are all flying out now, guys, let me tell you. Now I've decided to shuffle them. So don't try and make it fit. If it doesn't fit for you, then it's not for you. Maybe watch me on Sunday. But if there are bits that you can resonate with, then definitely see it as guidance, divine timing, okay? So what we're going to do first is we are going to shuffle the colour cards. My friend had these done earlier on today. I love these cards. And then let's see what is coming up for you. So let's just ask them peacefully. See what message. We'll ask the cards to link to the reading which comes up for you. And then we'll see. There. So I don't know what's at the top there. The lighting up card is at the bottom. White, maybe some white light meditation perhaps. That's when you breathe in white light and exhale white light. Right, there's a white paper there I've just seen. See, everything's just beautiful. Right, so let's get started. So let's see what card is coming up for you. Okay, so first card, what is coming up for my questioners? What first card is coming up for my questioners? What is coming in? That's two. No. Gonna do it. Oh, okay. So at the bottom of the deck there, the Knight of Swords. Okay, now Knights, when I see it at the bottom of the deck, kind of links with what's come up here, which obviously I will explain in a moment. But be prepared for all of a sudden some message coming in. Definitely could be from an air sign, so that's Gemini, Aquarius or Libra. Someone who could be younger than you or just display more immature traits. And you thought you just got rid of them. And then they come popping back in again. Two major arcana representing your position. So you've got the Moon and you've got the Hermit card, okay? So there is a really deep emotional connection coming in here. Now, whether or not you've had to deal with things yourself, like how you, you know, like we when we look at ourselves sometimes and we think, the way I'm looking at this isn't right, or the way that I'm dealing with this isn't right, my reaction isn't right. I need to assess why I am reacting in certain ways. I need to assess why I feel in certain ways. And the Moon card is all about that, okay? So the Moon is really, really... So one of the most intuitive and highly emotional cards to have, okay? Now, sometimes when this card comes up, it can be toxic traits, toxic habits, drinking too much, smoking too much, that type of thing. So just be mindful if you tend to go that way when you're triggered, or if you tend to, when it's a Friday, you think, oh, well, I've worked really hard this week. Just because it's a Friday and Saturday, your body doesn't know it's Friday and Saturday. So if you do find the excess is a little bit... poisonous to you right now, then just take a step back from that, okay? But it doesn't have to be either. The Moon card is basically saying to you that sometimes it's exhausting trying to get everything figured out. You know when you go to bed at night sometimes, guys, and you think, okay, well, tomorrow I know I've got to do this, I've got to do that. The Moon is saying, don't even think like that. Tomorrow hasn't come yet. Be in this moment. And you'll find that the cycles that the Moon goes through, you will go through the same. You will just be so much more accepting. You will just be so much more developing as time goes on. Because it's come up with the Hermit, which is the soul-searching card. Now, remember, the Star is just after the Hermit. He has it all along here, guys. It's in his lantern. It's the Star. So where the answers are within you. This is Virgo energy, Cancerian energy, so you could be either one of those zodiacs, but if not, don't focus too much on the zodiac. But this is saying it's all within you. There's been a shift, I feel, with either your external situation, big changes, or big changes in how you feel. Sometimes when the Moon comes up, also it highlights when it's the full moon, it's almost like the torch of the sky. It just highlights our life, and we think, I don't want to do this anymore. I don't want to be in this situation anymore. But again, it's linked to the thinking, the intuitive side. So what can you do about it? What can you change about your thinking? Which is why the Hermit is coming up here, okay? So he's soul searching, and sometimes you can have a lot of people around you but still feel like you're not connected. Lower back, this can be also. So if you're lifting boxes because you're moving, then watch your lower back. But that's just a heads up, okay? So really quite... it's a silent profundity, this combination, okay? And it's almost like the caterpillar to the butterfly type energy. But we'll see where this is going. Let's see if it escalates into being a beautiful butterfly. But let's see what's coming in from an external situation. You've got the Knight of Cups. So it's funny, you had the Knight of Swords in at the bottom of the deck, and now you've got the Knight of Cups card coming in here. Now this could be an offering to you, this could be a message of some sort, but I don't feel you're waiting for it, guys, at the moment, because I feel you've turned your back either on someone, something, some sort of situation, and it's just, it's not at the forefront of your mind. This could be why you have felt triggered and why you feel like you need to change your mind about how you think about certain things, you know, like getting in the loop, similar to the Five of Cups energy that we had today. This is what this means. So it's asking you to get out of your own head. Now, if that person was in your head a lot, the Hermit would suggest, of as difficult as it is sometimes, find your worth, find your frequency, find your tribe, find your vibration, find your hobbies, find your gifts, talents, because the Knight of Cups is here. But it's not going to be just yet, and I'm going to see why I feel the need to say that, okay? If this isn't a person you've already dealt with, then this could be an offering of some sorts or in any shape or form, okay? So let's see. It wouldn't be anything as grand as like somebody offering you a house or somebody offering you the CEO position, because it's a Knight energy. If it was, it'd be like an emperor, empress, that type of energy. But this is like an offering, even if it's, do you want to go out for a drink? Or even if it's, look, we've not been here for a while, do you want to do this? Again, it could be friends offering that to you, okay? So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to ask what else is coming into the questioner's position. Tell you what, guys, you've got two cards again. She says, the Empress at the bottom of the deck there. So finding your own inner harmony. I feel it's coming. I feel it's coming. The Hangman. This is what's going to happen. Or this is what it looks like is going to happen. By the way, it's with the Ace of Swords. So I'm going to read these as a combination. So you've got an Ace card and you've got another Major Arcana. So far, you have not been represented by one Minor. Okay, the Hangman with the Ace of Swords basically saying, when this energy comes in, now let's talk about it like a situationship, okay? So if you're questioning about somebody else, the Hangman is, this will, energy will come in either when you are literally waiting for it, which is why it's called the Hangman, but it will be longer. Watch Pot Never Boils, guys. The Hangman, but the spiritual lesson in this, because you've been through the dark night of the soul almost, what are you going to do about it? Here it is. He's been hanging around. He's been feeling lonely. He's been feeling confused. And all the chakras, all the light is going to his own enlightenment here. Okay? So when this energy comes in, do you say hi back? Do you get excited and think, oh, yes, this has happened now. I'm going to go meet this person for a drink. Or do you think, no, I've been through too much, because the Ace of Swords is calling me. And the Ace of Swords is going into a brand new phase, a brand new cycle. Not like the world type of cycle, but this is how you're thinking, okay? So you start to think differently, which is why you're starting off as the Moon. We have to address some stuff we don't want to address up, guys. We have to understand that the way we think can be all patterning ways. But the breakthrough is the Ace, brand new phase with regards to your own leadership, okay? And because it's coming up through a cloud there, it's through your foggy times, it's through your cloudy times, it's through your dark moon times, which is why it's twinned with the Hermit card coming up here, okay? This is communication also, so there is high communication, but how you maneuver yourself going forwards is integral to what you put back on a record, or do you put it back in the old sleeve and get something else and write your own song, okay? So the Ace of Swords is really trying to push you in the right direction, and with residual energy It just does that sometimes. If this isn't with regards to a situationship or relationship, then what this would be, some really nice offering. But you're bored. A lot of you are quite bored. And you're just thinking differently about certain things. So you could be thinking differently about the places you go, that you, it just doesn't vibe well anymore. The food you eat, the drinks you drink, just everything. And it's like, I need this emotional cellular memory shake-up, because I can't think differently and live the same type of life. It has to come into balance. And this is what's coming in quite nice. And this is why you've got two deep major arcana coming in as a first card in your position. Because if it was just a bit like, oh, I just want to eat more fruit, then you'd get a minor energy and it wouldn't be anything as significant. So I'm just going to see what is coming up underneath you. Bottom. So moving forwards, guys, with your own willpower, this is good. Anyway, so underneath you, you've got the Three of Pentacles, okay? So from all this comes recognition. That little guy on the pedestal there, he deserves to be there because he's worked hard. He's getting the right people looking at him because his gift, his craft has put him up there, okay? So he's working on these, like carving these, and he's really, really good at it. And before he may have thought, well, no one sees me, no one really understands me, and everyone seems to be taking all the glory without doing much. This is where it all changes. So this could be with reference to work, where you start to get recognized. This is promotion. But if it isn't promotion, then what this is doing, this what this is saying is, start to understand that because of the changes that you are making with yourself, you're starting to have that voice, okay? Now, not a physical voice, not so you're not running out in the streets shouting your name, but from this new transition of new thinking, you get this new transition of new way of working, okay? So if this isn't going out to work, this would be something that sometimes it can be paid, sorry, hobbies turning into paid work type of thing, because you're investing more in your soul, you're investing more in your time with you, okay? Before you could have wasted so much time on external situations, whatever that is, but now you're allowing yourself, and I think that's the key, to know that a transition doesn't take two meditations and that's it, and you think, okay, well, where's all the good stuff? It takes time. Be patient. Know what's going to be coming in. Underneath the Knight of Cups, let's see what is coming up. Well, it's so multi-carded today, I'm going to tell you that much. So you've got a Major Arcana and the Four of Cups, the Four of Swords. No, third time lucky. The Four of Wands coming up here. So justice will be done from an external situation. So if somebody treated you a bit less than, then there's going to be some comeuppance. Not like in a karmic sense where you see them like running and then fall over in front of everyone, nothing like that. But the Four of Wands is basically saying there will be some balance and harmony coming from that justice. So whether or not somebody apologizes to you, and the Page of Wands can suggest somebody reaching out, okay? So there is that kind of sprinkle of energy coating this reading a little bit, but the outside influence is really, really quite nice and it's quite promising. If that is something, guys, you are waiting for, you know, some of you are, but some of you might just sense that, you know, as time goes on, it's not going to happen, which is why you're kind of being forced to go within yourself and see why you're thinking certain things. But the Justice cards and the Four of Wands is saying that there will be an elevated sense of being, how what you're going to be experiencing, because it all balances out. Now, this might not be until October. October. Where did that come from? Anyway, October. But that's only the timeline it gives me. It could be well before then, okay? This is a Libra energy, so you could have been dealing with somebody with these types of qualities. Now, if this isn't with regards to a person, then everything you've experienced which has been out of balance, you're going to be celebrating so much more stability. If you've been looking for homes, you'll get one like that. If you've been looking for a partner, you'll meet somebody. If you've been looking for the right job, work, home balance, you'll get it, okay? So have no fear, but do you see why this is so important first? It's almost like flitting the day away and then wondering why you weren't productive. Now, it doesn't have to be doing things. It's on a mind level, scripting, whatever that is for you, whatever you feel you need to address, you know? So underneath the Ace of Swords and the Hangman, let's see what is coming in. Here he is again, guys. Here he is again. The Knight of Swords. Now, you've got the Ace of Swords and the Knight of Swords. This time, though, it's in your position, so I'm not reading it necessarily. Two knights in one reading, though, can mean more than one person interested in you. If we're going to look at it like that. But I'm going to look at it like the Knight of Swords is you this time, okay? Meaning, your action is so much more faster than what it is at the moment, okay? So he is, it's the fastest moving of knights. So he's racing ahead there with enthusiasm because he knows what he wants. He or she, he knows what he wants. He's going for it. Whereas before, well, now, you kind of know, but you're being a bit more hasty. You're being a bit more grounded because the Hangman is here. So there's no fast action, basically, at the moment. So you get clarity. Clarity is clearly coming in, but it happens after the justice, after the balance. Does that make sense? So it's almost like the mist is gone, the clouds are gone, and then you're seeing a clear day. You know that song, I Can See Clearly Now, The Rain Has Gone? It's like this. Put it on after this reading. It might resonate. Don't know who sang it though. Right, okay, so clarifier card. Let's see what is coming in as an overall clarifier. What is coming in? What is coming in? Oh man, this is beautiful. Ten of Cups. Happy. Look at them guys. Reflection of how you're going to be feeling. I'm glad. Do you know what? I know you can't see, but the cards were like this. And I just took a sneaky peek. I've got my clarifier, but I've just taken a sneaky peek. You've also got the Knight of Cups coming up here. I am confident some of you are going to hear from someone, if that's your question. Overall clarifies the Fool. Go with your intuition, which is what the Moon is asking you to do right now. She's holding a piece of amethyst there. The camera will focus. Amethyst is linked to the third eye. You can have your eyes closed but see where you're going, which is exactly what she's doing here. Okay, now the Fool energy, what I do want to say, mixed with the Knight of Swords, you don't want to be so enthusiastic about something that everything comes crashing down, but the neighboring cards would suggest it's a good omen. So just be mindful that all of a sudden when things start to fall into place, don't be too hasty. If you've been waiting for a bit of money, for example, when you get, I don't know, $2,000 in your account and think, oh yeah, but I really wanted that makeup and I really wanted that and I really wanted that, then when I get that, then I'm going to see what's left. You don't need a lot of stuff, you know? So it's just saying be a bit more mindful with that. If you've moved and you want the most extravagant whatever, then go to town, you know? Do whatever you need to do, but just be mindful because the Fool will always lead you to that empowering success. But you have to understand that with any new phase, especially with regards to how you're thinking with the Ace of Swords coming up here, it's just marshy ground. But it's a good omen. The Fool is a really, really nice card to have. And a lot of you are well within your comfort zone, but you know you are ready to get out of it. It's like trying to squeeze yourself in a little box. You wouldn't fit in it, and it's like uncomfortable. Why would you even do that? But some people stay in there because they have grown in that box, and they don't want to get out of it, okay? So now it's time to kick it down and stretch your arms, stretch your legs, and move forwards. But first, look at this. Look at this energy and think, why do I think certain things? Why do I feel certain things? And break free from that box. The as a timeline, the Virgo energy is September, which is the Hermit, okay? So, did you think of a colour? Let's see what is coming up. There, yes, look. Oh, man, this is excellent. So, you've got Lemon, which is access, innovative thinking. So, this brand new phase with regards to your thinking mind, the Ace of Swords, is it's saying access it. So, this is important, guys. It's there for the taking. Your mind is your greatest tool. Whatever you tell your mind, whatever you think, your thoughts that you think, will go in your body. And you'll just power through as you should. Or not so much. Who is this Knight of Cups? We'll see. Give it time. Give it time. That is your Tuesday evening tarot reading. Hope it resonated. If not, then don't worry. Watch me on Sunday. And the ones who are coming to my class should have received an email. And any questions about that at all, just send me a message. Other than that, guys, you take care. Have a beautiful Tuesday evening. And I will catch you, as always, in the next video. Bye-bye.